السلام عليك زين الأنبياء السلام عليك.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله، الله سبحانه وتعالى enabled us to fast and make qiyam in the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us those actions, inshallah ta'ala. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts one action only, then that's a guarantee that this person will go to Jannah. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our actions by His mercy, inshallah. And forgive all our shortcomings in the intentions and in the actions and our imperfections, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. And when we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we depend on the mercy of Allah and not our actions. Because our actions will never reach the level that Allah deserves. But His mercy will reach us, wherever and whoever we are. But this also brings to mind the need for us to remember Ramadan throughout the year. Because the purpose of Ramadan is to achieve taqwa. And taqwa is not seasonal. Taqwa is something that needs to be a lifestyle. It needs to be with us until we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barak ala Sayyid Muhammad wa ali. So taqwa needs to be with us at all times. So when we look and reflect on the speech of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he says to us, Ad-deenu al-mu'amala. Ad-deenu al-mu'amala. These are two words, but they are actually explaining to us what we need to do until we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this is one of the miracles of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the ability to say so little and mean so much. Utitu jawami al-kalim. I have been given the comprehensiveness of speech. Little words, but they can, so many books and so many volumes can be written and explained regarding what Rasulullah has said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا يَنْطُقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes him talk, and he talks on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. الدين المعاملة. Deen is dealings. So if one wants to see where he is in taqwa, in the scale of taqwa, he needs to look at his dealings. The dealings that he does between him and all creations. That is the gauge for us to know where taqwa stands in our life. And the ulama said that the first thing, your journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is this path, to achieve this taqwa and to achieve this excellent dealings with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and with His creation. So the ulama said that the first thing that will be fixed in any person starting his journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is his iman. He works on his iman becomes stronger as he is making a'mal and making adhkar and so forth and so forth, and he is passing through the journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his iman becomes fixed. Then what comes next after that? Still his deen is not fixed. He still hasn't reached deen yet. Then after iman, then ibadat becomes fixed. Because the iman, the more iman, the more perfection in ibadat. And his worship acts will become better and better. So his concentration in salah, his concentration and his devotion and in his worship acts will become better and better. Then next to that is akhlaq, is your manners. The manners will be fixed after the iman is fixed, after ibadat is fixed, then comes akhlaq, the manners in which you conduct yourself with. So now kindness, generosity, forgiveness, all of these beautiful qualities which Allah and Rasulullah ﷺ love, they start to develop in this person because of his iman, because of his ibadat, because of his because of that, akhlaq becomes better and better. After akhlaq, then you will see that mu'asharat becomes better. Mu'asharat means the social dealings, particularly between us brothers and sisters. So now, a sign of your iman being strong, a sign of your ibadat being strong, a sign of your akhlaq being strong, then you will see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you mu'asharat, will give you the social dealings in a way which He loves subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now you will see the beauty of the relationship between the Muslims in this state. So we should all strive to that. And then after that, only after that, after the iman is fixed, after the ibadat is fixed, after the akhlaq is fixed, after the mu'asharat, the social dealings are fixed, only then that you start to begin to fix your dealings, which is the commercial dealings, how we conduct our businesses. This is what Allah Rasulullah meant in the hadith, الدين المعاملة. This is the pinnacle. This is the pinnacle. الدين المعاملة. Deen is معاملة. When you reach a stage to fix your معاملات, your dealings, your business dealings, only then you can rest assured that inshallah your deen is good. Before that, there is a lot of work to be done. So for that, that's why Rasulullah ﷺ, we should not be surprised when Rasulullah ﷺ said, التاجر الأمين الصدوق مع الصديقين والنبيين والشهداء يوم القيامة. The merchant who is truthful and who is Amin means he keeps his trustworthy. Then Allah will put him in the Day of Judgment with the Siddiqeen, those who have reached the Siddiqiyya. With the Shuhada, those who have been martyred. With the Anbiya, those who have been, Allah has sent as prophets to mankind. He will be put with them. What was he doing? He was only selling and buying. He was only selling and buying. But that selling and buying was actually at the pinnacle of his deen. His iman was strong. His ibadat were strong. His akhlaq were strong. His mu'asharat were strong. Then naturally his dealings will be strong. So this is an advice for me to begin with, that until next Ramadan, this is our homework. This is our homework. How much of that will we be working to fix, inshallah ta'ala, so that next Ramadan, when it comes, we are more advanced in our deen and more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we receive the bounties of Allah in Ramadan. May Allah, inshallah, fix our hearts and fix our dealings and fix our akhlaq and fix our iman and fix our ibadat and fix our dealings. May Allah make us amongst those who are righteous and makes us with those whom He loves, both in this dunya and akhirah. وجزاكم الله خير سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
Thank you for watching one of Al-Maqasid's online educational offerings. Our mission at Al-Maqasid is to cultivate holistic learning environments rooted in knowledge, devotion, and service. For more information, please visit our website at almaqasid.org and connect with other online content at almaqasid.org/connect.